नमस्ते माय डियर फ्रेंड्स। ब्रिटिशर्स डिवाइडेड इंडिया इनटू नेशंस इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान। दे प्लेड ए ट्रिक विद इंडिया। आफ्टर द लिबरेशन freedom in 1947, Sardar Patel, he integrated various states of India into an integrated nation, but there were few states like Hyderabad, Jammu and Kashmir, etc. Now I am talking about Hyderabad. Nizam of Hyderabad, he was very cruel. With the help of Rajakars and all, many Hindus were massacred, but he was no match to mighty Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Patel forced the Nizam of Hyderabad to merge Hyderabad into India. Now, on 17th of September, Modi government celebrated Hyderabad Liberation Day. Now, let us know all about what the cruel acts were rendered to the Hindus in the Nizam regime. Although Bharat became independent on 15th August 1947, but simultaneously 562 princely states within India also got the choice to accede with either India or Pakistan. Home Minister Sardar Vallabh Bhai Jhaveri Bhai Patel and his trusted secretary and famous ICS officer V.P. Menon were entrusted with the responsibility of uniting the provinces into one nation. With efficient leadership and a brilliant strategy, Sardar Patel and V.P. Menon made the impossible possible, and within a year, 562 princely states were ready to merge with Bharat. But the areas which were still not merged with India were principally Kashmir, Junagadh, and Hyderabad. Among them, Hyderabad, not only the largest princely state, but its total geographical area was also way larger than the United Kingdom. The princely state of Hyderabad included many areas of states like present-day Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and Chhattisgarh. Hyderabad was then ruled by Nizam Usman Ali Khan, the seventh ruler of the Nizam Asaf Jahi dynasty. However, he was a mere puppet, as real power was in the hands of Qasim Rizvi, one of the advisors to the Nizam and a powerful leader, but is known today as the Majlis-e-Ittehadul Muslimin. Qasim was leading a private army of his own followers known as the Razakars. According to sources, the number of Razakars ranged between 20,002 lakhs. According to these Rajakars, either Hyderabad should have been an independent state where Sharia law would have been in force, or it should have been merged with Pakistan. Even though Hyderabad was ruled by radical Rajakars, the people there not only opposed their rule but were also willing to merge with India at any cost. Also, as Pakistan was about 1500 kilometers away from Hyderabad region, so it was not logical to talk about their inclusion. They would enter Hindu homes, drag the men out and murder them, followed by rapes of the girls and women. These violent acts were indescribable. In one instance, they started to stab and kill all the men. They dragged the last youngest brother to outside. His pregnant sister fell on him and started crying. The cruel murderers hit her on the stomach. She gave birth to a baby and died then and there. The child, being called Babu, is surviving today. Evil rule prevailed in the village on the day. They raped every woman that they came across. Several women became victims of Rajakars' sexual assault. The Rajakars resorted to the path of terror. They targeted non-Muslims and not only innocent people were sacrificed, but also the women and girls were mistreated. On the same lines as during the direct action violent in Bengal or during the partition of undivided Punjab, the Nizam allowed all these atrocities. It was decided that Hyderabad should be asked to sign a standstill agreement in which the Indian Army would be stationed outside the borders of Hyderabad and Hyderabad would treat its citizens fairly. But the Nizam refused to accept the proposal due to the fierce demonstrations and violence of Qasim Rizvi's Rajakars. The standstill without troop stationing could not sustain as atrocities on non-Muslim population were rising day by day, and finally Sardar Patel had to resort to the use of force. Military operations under Operation Polo began on 13 September 1948. The Indian Army forced the Rajakars to flee the battlefield. Finally at 5 p.m. on 17th September 1948, the Nizam announced a ceasefire. Major General Jayantonath Chaudhary accepted the surrender of Hyderabad. Chief of Army Staff Major General Sayyid Ahmad Al-Adruz and Hyderabad was officially merged with India. The state of Hyderabad was founded by the 5th Qutb Shahi Sultan of Golconda, Muhammad Quli, 1582-1612, on the banks of the Musi River in 1591, who built a city as a replica of Islamic heaven. On 21 September 1687, the Golconda Sultanate came under the rule of the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb and Mir Kamruddin Chin Kilich Khan, the son of Aurangzeb's general Ghazidun Khan Feroz Jung, became the ruler of the state, who claimed his ancestry to first Khalifa Abu Bakr. Hyderabad was a last remnant of Mughal Empire, which had a pivotal geographical position as it was surrounded by central provinces in North Bombay in west and Madras in east and south. It was a premier state with approximately 16 million population, ₹26 crore annual revenue and 82 2000 square miles area and having its own currency. British administration never treated Hyderabad differently in comparison to other states despite its premier position which the Nizam always aspired for. The 85% of population of the state were Hindus, but they were denied the civil, police and army position. These were close preserve of the Muslim. Even in 132 membered legislative assembly set up by Nizam, the Muslim were in majority. After the announcement of British government's 3rd June plan of formation of two states, India and Pakistan, the Nizam of Hyderabad, Osman Ali Khan Asaf Jan Shivan, issued a firman not to send any representative to constituent assemblies of India and Pakistan and became independent sovereign state. He sent a delegation headed by the Nawab of Chhatri to meet Lord Mountbatten to discuss the demand of Nizam to retrocess Berar to Nizam grant of dominion status to Hyderabad. Now, the Nizam's both demands were technically declined as Mountbatten opined that Berar was practically integrated with central provinces. Therefore, any changes in status quo can be changed with the consent of the people of the area. Similarly, dominion status of Hyderabad was also rejected as Mountbatten said firmly stated that his Majesty government will only accept through either of the two new dominions. These proposals were unacceptable and delegation returned to Hyderabad. The last Viceroy of India and the first Governor General after independence, Lord Mountbatten, was hopeful for Hyderabad's accession with India and he pleaded that some extra time should be given to Nizam to educate the 15% minority which was holding the most of top position. On 8th August, Nizam again wrote to Mountbatten to not accede with India but enter to an agreement with India with conditions of almost autonomy as independent sovereign state, especially the demand of privilege and not to ally with India in case of any war with Pakistan. After several rounds of negotiations in November 1947, Hyderabad signed a standstill agreement with the Dominion of India, continuing all previous arrangements except for the stationing of Indian troops in the state. However, with the rise of militant Razakars with whose support Nizam wanted to establish independent Islamic state, the life of majority Hindus became hell. In order to curb the menace of militant Razakars and Nizam, it became necessary for India to take punitive action against state of Hyderabad in September 1948, leading to surrender of Nizam and sign the final accession with India. In the Hindu majority Hyderabad, the Nizam ensured that Hindu did not even had access to fundamental rights. He tried to convert Hyderabad into a sovereign Islamic state. Nizam was a trusted friend of the British even during Lord Reading's time, and because of the confidence he enjoyed with British, he started singing independent Hyderabad tune. The Hyderabad people under foreign rule in an independent India started agitating for freedom. Nizam tightened the state machinery and furthered his oppressive dictatorial regime. He acquired a religious organization, Ittehadul Muslimin, to support himself and his regime. This organization started publicizing that Muslims were rulers and Hindus were ruled, and Nizam represented the power of Muslims. This religious organization inducted its religious army Razakars into the arena. The Nizam had multiplied the percentage of Muslims in Hyderabad by settling Muslims from other regions in Hyderabad. Majlis is more accurately described as a Muslim cultural religious organization allied with the Nizam's government that became increasingly chauvinistic in character as communication as communitarian conflict amplified in the state in 1930s. As for its ideal, the organization founder Bahadur Yar Jung had reduced the Nizam from the personification of sovereignty to its mere symbol by propagating the view that power resided not in the person of the ruler but in the community of Muslim believers who allowed him to rule. Following this logic, Hyderabad, according to the Majlis, should be declared as a Muslim state in which every Muslim became a participant and stakeholder in sovereignty. Nizam, whose ambition was to establish Islam Asafia Empire, Sultanate Asafia Islamia, proclaimed independence and declared himself His Majesty the Nizam after 1947. His was the most oppressive rule, implementing extreme brutalities on helpless Hindus. He wanted to be an independent kingdom in a newly independent Indian nation. He increased the Muslim religious influence with the organizational support of Ittehadul Muslimin and protected his regime with the cruelties unleashed by the Razakars. Even then, former British Prime Minister Winston Churchill supported independent Hyderabad and argued that it can remain as a buffer state like Switzerland is in Europe. In 1947, as per the then circumstances, Government of India said that those provinces which do not wish to merge into India or Pakistan can remain independent. Taking this as a pretext, Nizam felt that he could remain independent in mainland Bharat. The Nizam history reveals another historical truth. The Nizam royalty have always bowed down before every empire, initially the Marathas, afterwards French and later the British, to whom they remained loyal servants. This mindset reached its pinnacle when Nizam begged the British not to leave them helpless as the British Empire was withdrawing from India. In the fast changing events of the time, in the guise of his religion, Nizam made numerous efforts to remain independent. His fanaticism for Islam and brutal monarchy can be gauged from his own verses. Salathini Salaf Sab Ho Gaye Nazre Azal Usman Musliman Monka Tharil Sun Se Hai Nisan Baki. Islamic kingdoms have perished because of political changes, he Usman, but today your kingdom remain as a symbol for Muslims. Banda Nakhus Hua Sunke नार ये थकिल वे जान अही गए निस्त ये जुना पर. अल्लाह अकबर चांट स्टॉप्ड द ब्लोइंग ऑफ कॉन्चिज. इट इज डूम फॉर पीपल वेयरिंग द सेक्रेड थ्रेड युगना पवितम. द निजाम फेल्ट दैट मर्जिंग हिज किंगडम इन इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया इज एन इंसल्ट टू हिम एंड हिज रॉयल्टी. टू एडवाइज हिम ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मैटर्स, ही स्पेशली इन्वाइटेड वेल नोन लॉयर Malik Khan and paid him rupees 1 lakh as fees every day. As part of his plot, he did everything to instigate Islamic fanaticism in Muslim population. He felt that it would be dangerous to have states of independent India surrounding his kingdom, for which he would need a seaport. He even thought about buying Goa from Portuguese government. He understood that Government of India approach was against his own plans, and he knew it was impossible to fight with a very powerful Indian army. So he started making other efforts which include expanding his army and training them in guerrilla warfare, he decided to import arms and weapons from foreign countries as well as manufacture more weaponry from their own factories. As a second front, he developed the Razakar army. He specially brought Pathans to guard his borders. He made preparations to secretly import weapons in aircraft. He got aerodromes in Bidar, Warangal and Raichur renovated with a view to bring Muslim population at on par with Hindu population. In Hyderabad, he attracted Muslims from other states with many assurances and resettled them. He instigated caste disturbances between upper caste and Harijans and instigated one against the other. Razakars created terror by killing, looting villagers, burning homes and raping women. He had his loyalist Hindu minister Jinda cabinet. He rejected all positive suggestions from Government of India and continued with his nefarious designs. We already saw how he treated Government of India representative Sri K.M. Munshi, who came to Hyderabad as agent general. After some time, Hyderabad Kingdom's Prime Minister Mir Layak Ali went to Cheriyala for a visit. 1,000 villagers under the leadership of Imadi Razi Reddy went to him and complained about Razakar attacks. He simply told them to stay together with no other option. The villagers in the area started gathering weapons for their own self-defense. They obtained a cannon from Valla Patla Ramachandra Rao Deshmukh and mounted it on Bhairwani Pulli Burj Tower. Plenty of ammunition was always kept ready. The blacksmiths in the village started making iron balls and other weapons. Bekal, Dholi Metta, Thorasal, Jallapalli, Kondapur, Kutigal, Solipur, Ankusipur and many other villages prepared their own self-protection groups. Bhairwani Pulli became the anchor village for all these activities, hence Razakars focused on this village. Bhuvangiri Deputy Collector Iqbal Hashim regarded Bhairwani Pulli villages as rebels and prepared to attack them. The courage and valor of the villagers was like an open challenge to him. Hashim pounced upon the villages with his armed police force in the name of peacekeeping. He ruthlessly shot more than 40 innocent villagers dead in Koda Kandla village. Then with his 150-member armed police troops, he reached Bhairwani Pulli village. The guards on the top of Burj Tower noticed the troops' movement and beat the drums. In the pitched battle, Hashim's troop was trounced with the firepower of the small cannon. Defeated, Hashim vowed to take revenge and destroy the village. Encouraged with their victory in the battle, the people of Bhairwani Pulli grew more confident that they could face the Razakar's army fearlessly. But again, they faced Nizam's army. They did not think much about it. When they came to know that army surrounded their village, it did not occur to them to run away into the forest and save their life. Therefore, the complete destruction of Bhairwani Pulli village could not be prevented. By the sun rose, the daylight was spreading even as the two youth Maguttam Ramayya and Bhuvayamma were on the vigil standing on the watchtower. They were hit by cannon shots and collapsed immediately. Nizam government officials and army resorted to barbaric acts after their victory and destroyed Bhairwani Pulli as if they defeated the biggest rebellion. Jangama people hated the Nizam government after the massacres and brutal attacks in Bhairwani and Lingapur villages, but Nizam brought journalists from abroad by spending thousands of rupees, distorted the massacres of Dharnapalli and portrayed them as government taking measures to protect law and order. 80-year-old Sri Ira Setapatta Vanka of Gorta village stated recently that Nizam had exploited and impoverished the villages between 1928 and 1948. For 20 years, the Nizam enslaved the Hindus, exploited their hard work, and looted them. Nizam, whose ambition was to establish Islam Asafia Empire, Sultanate-e-Asafia Islamia, proclaimed independence and declared himself His Majesty the Nizam after 1947. A number of political organizations began to be founded with goals of bettering the economic and social plight of the majority Hindu community in the state. The Andhra Mahasabha was formed in 1936. This organization became the cover organization of the banned Communist Party of India, who was the vanguard of the peasant Telangana armed struggle. Nizam Muslim Majlis Operator Khasim Rizvi all tried their best to prevent Hyderabad merger into Indian Union and cheated the people. Nizam declared that Hindus and Muslims are as dear to him like his two eyes. He cleverly fooled the people by saying Hindus would be upset if Hyderabad merged with Pakistan and Muslims would not like if it merged with India. Hence, in these circumstances, it would be better if Hyderabad remained independent. He hid his ambitions and religious fanaticism and issued a decree declaring Hyderabad as independent. During the Rajakar's atrocities, role of RSS. During the Rajakar atrocities on Sunday, 4th August 1946, in the premises of a house on the north side of Warangal Fort in Warangal town, Swayamsevaks were standing in a row. They were singing Jhanda Uncha Rahe Hamara Vijay Vishw Tiranga Pyara and were saluting the Bharatiya tricolor, pledging that they would sacrifice their lives to protect the flag honor. After the song, the slogans Inqilab Zindabad, Bharat Mata Ki Jai, Mahatma Gandhi Ki Jai reverberated in the area. It is extremely surprising that in Warangal Fort area, which belonged to Nizam's chieftains, the Bharatiya tricolor was hoisted and freedom songs were sung. Before the police action, a few youths fought against the Rajakar's atrocities and protected Udgir and its surrounding areas with their amazing courage, valor, and discipline. The young men transformed into a united fighting force, battled against armed Rajakar's Nizam army, Rohillas, and Pathans with heroic valor and protected many villages for over 6 months. They fought the enemy valiantly and killed many Rajakars and police officials. The farmers group in Bidar district became a threat to Rajakars and police force. After police action, women while doing farming activity used to sing songs of farmer guerrilla. Thank you for watching this wonderful video. Namaskar, my dear friend. Thank you.